much. I have a request though for next year, if she could lobby the Alberta government to rotate the legislature by about 180 degrees, so that next year we can demonstrate on the south side and have some sunshine solar energy for free. I don't know if you saw the website today at the climate march, there was a picture of Paris. You might have heard that because of the terror attacks, they banned the climate march in Paris. They were expecting 400,000 people. So instead, a lot of people put their shoes on the ground where the climate march was taking place. So in solidarity with Paris, I'd like you all to take off your shoes and put them in front of you. I won't be joining you today for medical reasons, but please go ahead. 2015. All right. Solidarity with Paris, right there. Well done. 2015, what a year. The first government in the history of Alberta that actually serious about climate change was like in May of 2015. Give a big round of applause for that. October 2015, the first time in 10 years that we have a government again that is serious about climate change. Again. Great step forward. Just 7 days ago, we had another historic announcement. For the first time, we have a price on carbon, we have a coal phase out, and we have a goal of 30% renewables by 2030. Awesome. So what do you think is the best source of green energy in Canada?
Sun.
The sun?
Yeah.
Anything else?
Wind.
Wind, good one. What else? What? Actually, the number one source of green energy in Canada is our megawatts. What are megawatts?
Energy efficiency.
Exactly. In fact, our RMI estimates by 2050 we can supply 53% of the world's energy needs through energy that we don't use, megawatts. So, conservation, exactly. I mean, we want a hot shower and a cold beer and a hot coffee, not necessarily in that order. We don't really need to burn 30,000 kilowatt hours a year for heating and 10,000 kilowatt hours or 8,000 for electricity. We just want these services. So how can we achieve that? We're already in Edmonton. We're actually the national capital for the most net zero buildings in the country.
Yeah!
Buildings that take only a small fraction of the energy required to heat and operate the building. And then, of course, once we achieve efficiency, then we can meet the rest of the needs much more easily with renewable energy. The energy efficiency target of the provincial government alone would create about 8,000 jobs in the province. If we and you know that the carbon pricing is about $3 billion in revenue. If we invest only one-third of that money into energy efficiency, we can create 46,000 permanent jobs in Alberta. So, if you're in favor of 46,000 green jobs in Alberta, stand three times. All right. I think the guy in the second row only stand twice. You don't care about the movements? Okay, anyway. So, with 46,000 jobs in efficiency, another 8,000 jobs in renewables, there's over 53,000 jobs. The jobs in oil sands, direct jobs, are only 21,000. That is a very significant number. And we'll diversify our economy. I think that's all I have to say. Thank you very much.